after the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder to rule in your name over all you have made and forever praise you with your mighty words through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And so with all the angels we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this memory of me." Thanksgiving, this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Hilton, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely and pray in help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your noble church on earth, with your servant Francis Archon, Mark our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you gain for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you summon before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say,
thank you.
all grace and all thanksgiving, be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all grace and all thanksgiving, be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all grace and all thanksgiving, be every moment thine.
Let us pray. May partakers of Christ through these sacraments humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conformed to his image on earth, we may merit also to be his co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Just a few announcements. First of all, we can remember the following for whom the Mass has been offered. Daniel Francis O'Sullivan and John Angelo Papilinski and all of them passed away recently, as we say,
eternal rest granted to them, O Lord, and their perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Amen.
We'll see from the newsletter that there'll be Mass at 9 o'clock on Monday. The rest of the week there's no Mass. I'm going away for a few days break. This Sunday coming, you're going to have a missionary priest, the missionaries of Africa, we know them as the White Fathers. He's coming, Father Michael, to give you a talk on the work, and there'll be a retiring collection for the White Missionaries of Africa, so I do urge you to be generous. I think that's about it on the Masses. PCPT fundraising ball. Deacon Garfield, the volunteers, those with green fingers, come step forward. He's looking after the area behind the church. I suppose perhaps none of you realise, but you don't realise there's a huge area of grassland behind those trees. And obviously we need to sort of conserve that or develop it, and he's looking for volunteers to help. So if you can help him, we'd really appreciate it. Also, I suppose it won't be part of the price, but you get a trip to Malta if you join them, won't you? There we are, if you want to do that as well. And also, there's a chosen on this Wednesday, the 21st of August, the show series 4, I think it was really chosen. Finally, pray for peace, not just in Ukraine, but pray for everything else, but for our own country, as we say.
Mary, our Lady, Mother of God, we ask you to intercede for the people of Ukraine and the world, for their government and those suffering across the world. Give them the necessity of the Son, suffering the cross of Calvary. Give them the strength and courage to take hope and justice. May we be the ones to support them to prevent atrocity. The human life may be saved, and the aged may be healed, and the dead may rest in peace.
And there's refreshments downstairs after that, so hopefully you come and join us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
For in peace you will find the Lord by your
life. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
suffer